हाय गाइज, वेलकम बैक टू यूट्यूब चैनल फाउंडेशन केमिस्ट्री एवी। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट रिडॉक्स टाइट्रेशन। सो दिस विल बी हाईली बेनिफिशियल फॉर 11th एंड 12th क्लास स्टूडेंट्स। सो आई हैव अ सिंपल मैसेज फॉर यू, प्लीज थिंक फॉर इनोवेशन, ऑलवेज बी क्रिएटिव, लर्न एवरीवेयर एनी टाइम एंड हेल्प टू लर्न अदर्स। So there is a disclaimer for this experiment. So in this experiment, approximate data are used to give a flavor about the real experiment, calculation part and conclusion, and better understanding about the experiment to the students. So if you carry out your own experiment, you will get your own original data, and it may happen that the result may vary from person to person. So the aim of the experiment is to determine the strength of potassium permanganate solution using standard oxalic acid of strength n by 10. So what are the apparatus required for this experiment? Burette with burette stand, pipette, pipette bulb, conical flask, graduated cylinder, beaker, volumetric flask, wash bottle. So now we will recognize these apparatus. So you can see here, this one is burette with burette stand, this one pipette, conical flask, beaker, volumetric flask, measuring cylinder, wash bottle, weighing machine, Bunsen burner, glass funnel, filter paper. So most of the apparatus are usually used in titration experiment. What are the chemicals required? We need KMnO4 solution, N by 10 oxalic acid solution, 6 normal sulfuric acid solution. So what is the basic principle of this redox titration? So we take the chemical potassium permanganate. So potassium permanganate ionizes to give MnO4 ion, minus ion and K plus ion. So in the presence of H plus acid, sulfuric acid, MnO4 minus ion will accept 5 number of electron to be reduced to Mn2 plus. So the oxidation state of MnO4 minus manganese has in plus 7 state, and it is reduced to Mn2 plus. So it accept 5 number of electron. So that means MnO4 minus ion reduced to Mn2 plus. And in oxalic acid case, oxalic acid H2C2O4 that ionizes to give rise to C2O4 2 minus ion oxalate ion and 2 H plus ion. And this oxalate ion C2O4 2 minus will be oxidized to carbon dioxide, and it will lose 2 number of electrons. So in KMnO4 case, 5 number of electrons are involved in the reaction, and in oxalic acid case, 2 number of electrons are involved in the reaction. So the net chemical reaction is MnO4 minus plus C2O4 2 minus plus 8H plus give rise to 2 Mn2 plus plus 10 CO2 plus 8 water. So now we need to know what is the equivalent weight of KMnO4 and oxalic acid. From reaction, we know the in case of KMnO4, 5 number of electrons are involved or in business. So the equivalent weight of KMnO4 will be molecular weight by the number of electrons involved or in business. That will be 158 by 5. That is equal to 31.6 gram. And the equivalent weight of oxalic acid will be molecular weight by the number of electrons involved. That is 2. So 126 by 2 is 63 gram. So we can prepare a standard solution of 0.1 normal oxalic acid by dissolving about 1.575 gram of oxalic acid by dissolving in 250 ml of water in volumetric flask. So what is the actual procedure we need to follow? So initially we need to wash burette, pipette and conical flask thoroughly with tap water and then with distilled water. Then the burette was rinsed thrice with supplied KMnO4 solution. Then it was filled with KMnO4 solution just below the 0.0 level. So first of all, we should know what are the marks available in the burette. So if you look at the burette, you can see some marks here. They are not visible. If you come to the lab, you can see it is starts from 0.0 to up to 50.0. So it is advisable to take the KMnO4 solution just below the 0.0 level, and it need to be fixed with the burette stand by removing the air bubble if any, and then you need to note down the initial burette reading by looking at the lower meniscus. Then the pipette was rinsed thrice with oxalic acid solution and 25 ml of n by 10 oxalic acid solution was pipetted out into a 250 ml conical flask. Then 50 ml 6 normal sulfuric acid was added. Then the reaction mixture was warmed to about 50 to 60 degree Celsius. Then the KMnO4 solution was added to the hot solution. It was added till a permanent faint pink color persists. So here the KMnO4 will act as a self indicator. So this is the end point of the titration. So at this point, you need to stop the addition of KMnO4. And the volume of KMnO4 consumed was noted down. So you note down the final burette reading, and you if you take the difference, so that will give you the volume of KMnO4 consumed for this specific titration. And the same process was repeated until three concordant readings were obtained. So the titration readings you need to note down in this tabular manner. So for first titration, you have taken the volume of oxalic acid 25 ml, and whatever the initial burette reading you have to note down here, and final burette reading after the end point, and you get the difference. So that will be the rough. And you need to do another three experiments, similar experiments, so that you will get the concordant reading. So for example, you get initial burette reading 0.9 and final burette reading at the end point, you get 28.5. So the difference will be 27.6. So this will be the rough. Then you repeat for another three titration, and you noted down initial burette reading and final burette reading, and you get the difference. So here you in each case, you get 26.9 ml as differential value. So these are called concordant reading. So suppose you get different readings, so you need to take the average. Then how to calculate? The strength of oxalic acid we know, 0.1 normal, that is let's say N1. And volume of oxalic acid used equal to 25 ml, let's say V1. So let the strength of KMnO4 is X normal, so that is let's say N2. So volume of KMnO4 used in the titration, that we already know, 26.9 ml V2. So since the strength of KMnO4 can be calculated by using the equation V1N1 equal to V2N2. So we can easily find out N2 equal to what? V1N1 by V2. So here you can see 25 into 0.1 by 26.9. So that is 0.929 normal. Hence the actual strength of KMnO4 number was found to be 0.929 normal. So I will be happy if you guys subscribe to our channel Foundation Chemistry AV, and this is also available in the website www.foundationchemistryav.com. So this is a simple step towards e-learning, making life better. Thank you all for learning.